Hello and welcome to Farming Simulator 2017 Mod Showcase with me, Kevin Sawyer. Hope you guys are all well and enjoying your day, whatever you're up to. Right, as I've been saying in the last sort of like episodes and streams and that, I was going to show you how to do a mod case on this, which is the winery. Now, from what I understand, this is version 4.1 of this mod. Now, it's a kind of, this is going to be a kind of revisit of a mod showcase I've already done, which was of the actual of this mod, but it was an older edition. It was version 1. So I'm not going to cover the whole mod as you would get it when you download it, because I will explain why in a sec, but I've already covered this side of the mod showcase. So what I'll do is I'll remember to put a little link in the video, just so to direct you towards this aspect of it, which is producing the grapes and everything. You should see that pop up in the right hand corner now. So if you want to watch that later on, please do. Once you finish watching this, you can go and watch that first part of it. I'm not going to cover that in this mod showcase, purely because it's just a it'd be sort of like broken record syndrome. But I'm going to cover the bits that he's now added into this mod showcase. Well, sorry, into this mod, I should say, which is this part and like another little bit, which is the pub, as I call it. But anyway, I digress. First of all, get the boring bits underway. So once you've downloaded this, and obviously, as like I said, this is version 4.01. So if you're watching this mod at a later date, the modder may have come in and changed the functionality aspects on how this mod actually works. So please bear that in mind if you download this at a later date. The mod offer is called Susi28. I'm going to show you where it is. So obviously, once you've downloaded and installed it into your mods, one thing I will say to you guys, if you've got the older version, version 1, there is a way round of changing your existing, because the newer version 4, has a different name to it. What I did is I changed the actual mod name in my folder to the current version of it, and then when I installed the newer version, it just then replaced it. However, doing that, you may run into the same problems as I have, so you may be better off just if you can deleting the old one and then installing a new one. You might not run into the same problems as I have, but anyway, I'll show you where it is in the mod in the placeables listing. So if I scroll back down to here, and I think this is what sort of like where it's sort of like the older version and newer version are sort of like running side by side, but pretty much that is the winery now in current version. So if you buy that, if I show you, if you press buy, it's still zero to buy. You can see you get your generic placeable vineyard, and then you've obviously got this aspect, which is the actual where it produces the wine for you, and that costs 800,000 to buy. It's not cheap, and it's £2,000 per day or whatever currency you're working in to maintenance per day. And then last but not least is this part of it. This is what I call the pub. This is where you go and sell your actual goods to. It's kind of a two-part mod, and I'll go into reasons why it's two-part mod when I get to that part of the mod. But that costs £120,000 to buy and £1,000 per day in maintenance. And like I said before in the previous mod showcase, you're going to need a good bit of big flat land to place all this and get it to work. This bit here comes in the pack as well, and that's like a trigger, because when you place this down, there's like a little place bit where you can stick the trigger for it. It's in German, so I can't tell you what that actually says, but I'll show you whereabouts it is when you get it. I'm sure, I'm not 100% sure, but I don't know whether I got it as part of the pack as well, but you may find there's like a little lardy part in there. I didn't need that, so I didn't actually bother with it. Basically, it's like a place where you can where you can actually store all the goods for it. But anyway, that might have been like the additional version or copied version. I'm not 100% sure, but I'll get on with the mod showcase. I'll quickly show you around the facility and show you quickly where the place points are. It's quite well detailed, and so I'll quickly go upstairs. Here is like the instrument dial-up box. This is where you can read what's going on with the machine. If I bring up this, oops, not that. It should then have a little pop-up. If I walk over to there we go. So as you can see, it shows you the little diagnostics there for what's going on, and the little diagnostics there, security camera there as well. This is one of the tip points. You can tip in here, and you can tip in here. That's for the grapes as well. I'll go through it in a sec. As I said, I'm just quickly glossing over what where the tip points are. This is the where the pallets are produced, so you're going to see them in a sec once I get it up and running. And this is the tip point for the water. So, and this is all this needs, is water and grapes, and you're good to go. And it was far up, and away you go. But I'll go cover that in a sec. Let's go and jump over to the Deer John, or John Deere over here. And I'll start off by tipping off the grapes in there. Let's back up a bit. Hitch up this tractor. This trailer. I've already gone and filled this up with grapes. Now you can try do it. Take the grapes you harvest from there directly to there if you wish. But just for demonstration purposes, I'm just going to skip that step just to make this video a bit shorter. Stitch that up. Get rid of the dial-up box as we drive through into this bit. Turn the old beacons on, beacon view. So you can drive up to point A, point A or point B. It doesn't matter as long as you get, you don't crash like me. What have I snagged? Well, it might be because I've snagged trailer there, so I snagged into the building. I might have snagged into the building slightly. It is a bit tight, so bear that in mind. Might be better off using a bigger vehicle or a smaller vehicle getting here. And that's why it says it's best to have it on a flat point. Why won't you let me in there? I'm gonna try going that way. Because it's more of a straight run. That's better. Come on. I'm going to have to get a run up on this, am I? Yeah. I think this trailer's too big for this. You're probably better off using the smaller trailer in there, to be fair. As you can see, it's going to nag the bigger trailer. Let's try that again. Let's try getting a bit of a run up on it. Come on up here. That's it. Wait until the tip point comes up. Should come up any point soon. There we go. Sorry about the camera, it's snapping around in the yard. Once you, again, point A, point B, same sort of situation. Once you get to that point and you see the tip symbol come up, press your tip trigger. Which is I, is the default is I. But you may have remapped it, so whatever you've mapped it to. Tip your grapes in. Try and get back out the yard if you can. Not make a ham sandwich as I have. Yeah, I'd say this is why this bigger trailer is probably not a good idea on this. Smaller trailer is probably more practical. Gonna have to do more runs, which is a downside, but you're better off in the long run trying to use a smaller trailer rather than a bigger trailer like I have, and making yourself look like a right idiot like I have. Let's just jump back in the cab quickly. Once you've tipped your grapes in, let's quickly park this up over here, out of the way. Obviously, then the next bit would be grab your water. I'm using my milk bowser at the moment, my universal. I've painted it white because that's, I tend to use that for milk, but water won't harm it in any way. Come on. Again, it's been a bit tricky. I didn't get enough of a run up. That's again because the slope's quite steep. And this is why it's probably a good idea to make sure this is on a flat bit of land. It's probably not the ideal tractor to use for this either. It's probably not powerful enough to tow that weight over that hill. Got there in the end. The tip point should be here, so then when you again, once you reach that tip point, press your generic unload key. Oh, got to attach the PTO first, naturally. I forgot to do that in all the excitement. Fill up your old water bowser. In fact, if I jump out, you should see a little there we go. It's already fired up. And we'll quickly walk over to the text box over here. See it's all up and running. Get a slip of text. Of course it's in German, so I can't read that, but as you can see, you've got the water topping up. Grapes already in. It shows you black pallets in the sector as well. I could run over here and turn the light on so you guys can see a bit better. You see the grapes pouring into the facility there. And then it all running into that. I'll see if I can run into that. Jump. Nope. Don't let me. It all tips off in that from there. Goes across that conveyor belt, as you can see it sort of pours into this clear tank, so you can see it mixing up. And then you start to get, more or less straight away from the get-go, you start getting your pallets producing on here. And then your barrels producing on here. And there should be another one. And then there's palletized barrels on there. Should be empty by now. Yep. you're going to, I'll probably make a recommendation, if you're going to, if you do get the same problem as me and you've got it on a ramp, a slight ramp, definitely probably better off using a powerful tractor if you've got a bigger trailer, or use a smaller trailer just for this aspect of it. Because as you can see, I had troubles just getting it up and down that hill. I don't know, the fence probably pull up the hill quite easy, but I grabbed the John Deere here just because it was nearest to this setup. Alright, anyway, just quickly run over and I'll fast forward time, and I might even just fast forward to the next day so you guys can see the next bit of it in daytime rather than a darkish avenue. If I fast forward time here, you can see it starts producing the pellets. It's not a quick process. It does take time for it to do this. You see, I think that's full at 49. Don't see it crawl. No, maybe not, still creeping up. Right, so that's full at 50. Let's slow time down again. That's full at 1,497, and that's full at 1,497. So what I'm going to do, use the old super strength just to pick these pallets up and take them outside. Throw them out there like so. And I'll pick them up in a sec, just to save me going in here with the tractor again. Super strength engage. It's heavy. Alright, walk it over to... You can hear the bottles jangling away. Don't want to smash them too much, so I'll place that down a bit carefully. And then last but not least, you can get your beer keg. Pick that up, and then let's again start, should be good to go, start producing more wine for you. Anyway, I'll detach this and then I'll drive down to my other place point, which is down by another part of the farm, and I'll fast forward time so it isn't actually dark anymore as well, so we'll try and do it the next morning. So I'll see you in a minute. Hello guys, welcome back, and you join me, it's a bit wet this morning, but you join me on the next morning on the farm, and I'll show you the concluding part of this, which is the where you can sell it all. Like I was saying earlier, see down here, there's this, it's got a little notice here, and as you can see, it's in German again. I can't tell you what that actually means, but I'm going to show you what you need to do. So basically, once you've again, once you've placed this, the pub part of it, sorry, you'll need to buy this, and as you can see, it's got a sales point, it's a trigger for wine shop. So you can I guess you can just throw all your wine directly in there, or your grapes in there as well. You can just bring your grapes up to that and then throw them directly into there if you really wish to. That's probably an option as well. But I'm only guessing. As I say, I haven't actually tried this off screen as yet. I'll have to try it when we get some grapes and see what happens. But to place it, you see these little markings, the yellow markers out here. I won't place it now because I don't need to, because I've already placed it. But I'll show you what you need to roughly do. So you buy that one. Once you buy that, or once you select it, obviously try and place it. If I can get in there and rotate. Rotate. That's a bit. Rotate. No, can't place there, I know. It says I can't place here because I've already got one down, but you'll get the idea. And once you get it roughly similar sort of situation to where that is, place it, and then it should give you the tip point as well. And I think that's where you can sell the grapes and that directly too. Mind you, saying that's tucked behind these trees, which doesn't help, so you'd have to try and back your vehicle up into these trees or whatever. But anyway, I digress. Let's show you how the rest of this goes. So I'll engage super strengths again. So first things first, let's take this up to here. Throw it in, and if I walk down here, you should see one of these cellars has grapes in it. Well, not grapes, but bottles, and it's all sitting in here. Then I'll get back out, spin round. Walk back up here, and then if memory serves me right, bottles start appearing, or something starts appearing around here. Let's have a quick look around here quickly. Ah, yeah. This dude appears. I don't think he was here earlier. But as you've loaded it up more and more, the more stuff starts appearing. So, right, so I'll grab a barrel next. That you can then just, I believe you can throw that directly again down around the back here. Let's test that. Nope, maybe not. Maybe that goes round the side here then. Hang on. Oops. Throw this round here. Maybe. Or maybe not. I think that's for the pallets. So, where do these go, the single barrels? They should go around here, I think. Maybe it's actually in the cellar, maybe I have to walk it down. Walk it down to the cellar and see what happens. Yeah, there it is. Missed it. So yeah, that's where the single barrels go. You throw your single barrels into this, and then it should, again, you see them just pop up in there. There should be some more bits and pieces appearing as we load up more in here. Let's have a quick look around, see if there's anything different. Nothing different as yet. So I'll keep them loading it up. I'll grab the pallet of beer from the as well. Grab a pallet of beer. It's getting super strength. Don't mess with a farmer, right? Yeah. It's like, yeah, he's like the Incredible Hulk. Throw that in there. Yeah, that's what I figured. I just got things mixed around. It's down in here for the pallet and then down the cellar for the other bits. And again, you should see a little trigger telling you how much you've got in here. Telling you fill level, everything. Pop round here, see if there's anything any different. Not yet, but I'll fast forward it a minute. Once we fill it up a bit more, might just need a bit more filling up. As you can see, you're getting harvest income slowly from it as well. What I might do is just test, see if you can sell these directly with one of these to that sales point. Nope, that must be for the grape sales point then. So I'm assuming you can sell grapes directly to that. Oh, smoke coming out the chimney, so I don't think that smoke was coming out before. Oh, I got music as well. And because I don't know that music is copyrighted, let me just mute the game sound just to be on the safe side. Sorry guys in advance. Now here we go, we've got bottles appearing. The music is playing, again, because I don't know if it's copyrighted or not. I just don't want to take the risk of it. Give me a copyright strike. We've got people appearing, though. Can keep them going. Ooh. People chatting in the background as well. It's like the sounds of a typical sound of a pub, music, people talking loudly, etc., etc., etc. The more you fill it up, the more stuff appears, pretty much. As you can see, guy drinking here on his own. Music's playing. There's more bottles on the tables here. And the more there's an invisible bottle there, but I guess a guy will appear there eventually. But the more stuff you get in this, the more people we get appearing. But anyway, I hope that hope you guys enjoyed that mod showcase. If you did, again, please feel free to like. And if you know anyone else that may also enjoy the mod showcase, again, guys, please feel free to share. It helps me out a lot, and I don't mind. And if you're new to my channel and see future mod showcases or anything else that I'm working on, please don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in the next one. TTFN.